So a very good morning to all of you guys and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for all the government exams. PIB say jo PIB ke news hote hain usme se aksar questions aate hain and most of the questions are picked from the PIB only. All right, because jo newspaper wagaira mein bhi bahut sari news aisi hoti hain jo ki PIB se hi aati hain. To agar hum ye bhi kahe ki newspaper se aaya tha to newspaper mein bhi PIB se hi aata hai. All right. So let's begin with the session, guys. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also ask any doubt. You can also follow me here. This is my Instagram ID. You can also ask your doubts here. So, aap doubt puchne wale bano. Bahut sare channels hai to ask your doubts. So let's move ahead to the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to the credit guarantee scheme for subordinated debt for MSMEs, and you have to identify the correct statements. So regarding this scheme, credit guarantee scheme for subordinated debt for MSMEs, aapko correct statement identify karna hai. Now the question is that scheme newly launched? Kya ye abhi launch hui hai? But nahi, aisa nahi hai. Remember, this scheme was launched during the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. Atmanirbhar Bharat package jab launch hua tha, uska pehla version. So I hope you all know that there are three versions of Atmanirbhar Bharat, three editions of Atmanirbhar Bharat, or you can say Atmanirbhar Bharat jo pehla wala launch hua tha usme ye wali scheme launch hui thi jiska naam tha credit guarantee scheme for subordinate debt for MSMEs. This is in news because it has been recently extended. It has been extended and it will now remain in operation. It will now remain operational till 31st March 2022. 31st March 2022 tak ke liye isko extend kar diya gaya hai, and that is why it is in news. So agar koi scheme news mein hoti hai, then we have to discuss some basics about that particular news, because it is a chance, there is a chance that the question can come from that particular scheme jo bhi news mein hai. Okay, so let's talk about the news. Basically guys, this is a guarantee cover scheme. Under this scheme, guarantee cover worth rupees 20,000 crore is being provided to the MSMEs, to the promoters of MSMEs, and this amount they will you know, invest in the stressed MSMEs. जो उनकी MSMEs जो stressed हो चुकी हैं due to COVID and due to certain other reasons, उनके अंदर वो amount invest किया जाएगा ताकि उन MSMEs को दोबारा से revive किया जा सके, so that those MSMEs can be once again revived. Okay. The objective of this is to extend support to the promoters of the operational MSMEs which are stressed. Okay. Of course, stressed MSMEs के लिए ये सबके लिए नहीं है, profit making MSMEs के लिए नहीं है. All right. And have become NPAs as on 30th April 2020, yani 30 April 2020 tak koi MSME agar stressed ho gayi hai aur wo ek NPA ho gaya, uska sara ka sara asset jo hai wo non performing ho gaya hai, then under this particular scheme some credit is being provided, credit will be provided to that stressed MSMEs. Okay, now what how much amount of credit will be provided? So the credit will be provided which is equal to 15% of the promoter's stake. There नहीं है यहाँ पे प्रमोटर्स, 15% ऑफ द प्रमोटर स्टेक और रुपीज 75 लाख, विच एवर इज लोअर. सो लेट अस से कि प्रमोटर का जो स्टेक है वो 1000 करोड़ का है. ठीक है, 1000 करोड़ का 15% कितना हो जाएगा, 150 करोड़, 150 करोड़. सो आउट ऑफ 150 करोड़ एंड 75 लाख, विच इज लेस, ऑफकोर्स 75 लाख इज लेस, तो 75 लाख रुपीज विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन दिस केस. ओके, 15% ऑफ द प्रमोटर स्टेक और रुपीज 75 लाख, विच एवर इज लोअर, is being provided to the promoters of MSMEs which are stressed. All right, and this has to be returned in a maximum period of 10 years with the 7 years ka moratorium period hai. There is a moratorium period of 7 years, while the maximum tenure for repaying the loan is 10 years. All right, do remember this, 7 saal aur 10 saal wali baat yaad rakhenge. Now promoters will infuse this amount in the MSME unit as equity, as I told you, and 90% guarantee coverage for this subordinated debt will be under the scheme, and 10% would come from the concerned promoters. जो भी total amount होगा उसमें 90% तो चलो government देगी और 10% promoter का भी उसमें contribution होगा. ठीक है, ऐसा नहीं है कि पूरा का पूरा पैसा government को होगा. So if the government is giving 75 lakh rupees, then out of this 75 lakh rupees, 90% will be the guarantee cover from the government, while the 10% of 75 lakhs will be borne by the promoter, or will be contributed by the promoter. And repayment period ka maine aapko bata diya, moratorium is 7 years and the total maximum tenure for repaying is 10 years. Okay, So now let's come back to the question, guys. You have to identify the correct statement. Guarantee cover worth ₹20,000 crore is being provided to the promoters. Yes, correct. Credit equal to 15% of promoter's stake of rupees or ₹75 lakhs, whichever is lower, is provided. Correct. Maximum tenure for repayment is not 8 years. It is not 8 years. It's 10 years. Maximum period कितना है? 10 साल. So only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Option B. ऑप्शन बी इसका सही जवाब होगा, ओनली 1 and 2. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. नेम द ICMRs व्हिच इज इंडियन काउंसिल फॉर मेडिकल रिसर्च इनिशिएटिव व्हिच हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. हु इज द यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर? इट्स मिस्टर मनसुख मंडाविया. मनसुख मंडाविया इज द यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. Which will be used to deliver vaccines with the help of drones. So this is a very innovative project. Although there is already a project of Telangana government which is known as Medicine from Sky. Medicine from Sky project hai Telangana government ka. They are already delivering vaccines and medicines with the help of drones to the primary health centers. But now this project of ICMR has been launched by Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare in the northeastern area. Let's talk about the news. What is the news? The initiative or the name of the drone you can say, or the program, anything you can say, it is iDrone. And iDrone stands for ICMR's drone response and outreach in northeast. This is the full form. No need to remember the full form, yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Just remember the name of initiative or the project. This is iDrone, and this project is for delivery of COVID vaccinations in the hard to reach places. Aisi jagah jahan pe रोड के थ्रू या कन्वीनियंटली नहीं जाया जा सकता, वहां पे ड्रोन्स के थ्रू वैक्सीन विल नाउ बी डिलीवर्ड थ्रू दिस प्रोजेक्ट इन द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न एरिया. एंड रिमेंबर दिस हैज बीन अप्रूव्ड, दिस हैज बीन गिवन ग्रांटेड इन नागालैंड, मणिपुर एंड अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड. ठीक है, नागालैंड, मणिपुर एंड अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड. एंड द वेरी फर्स्ट ड्रोन डिलीवर्ड वैक्सीन फ्रॉम बिश्नुपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल टू लोकताक लेक इन मणिपुर. ठीक है, मणिपुर में पहला कोई बिश्नुपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल है, वहां से लोकताक लेक मणिपुर में वहां पे वैक्सीन डिलीवरी हुई है. एंड दिस जर्नी वाज ऑफ अराउंड 15 किलोमीटर्स व्हिच वाज कवर्ड इन 12 टू 15 मिनट्स. ऑलराइट, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज गाइज, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो आई होप यू कैन इजिली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ द नेम ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव इज iDrones. ऑप्शन बी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. Now let's talk about the question number 3. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the Tax Inspectors Without Borders program? Tax Inspectors Without Borders program ke respect mein aapko incorrect statement batana hai. All right. So this was few months ago. This was in news because this program was launched in Bhutan. Bhutan and the partner administration was India in case of Bhutan. Theek hai, under this project. And this is now in news because this Tax Inspectors Without Border program has now been launched in Seychelles. In Seychelles. So the Tax Inspector Without Border program has been launched in Seychelles. And I hope you all remember that this program is the initiative. It is a joint initiative of UNDP and OECD. UNDP and OECD ka ye joint initiative hai. I hope you all know this. And this has been launched to strengthen, of course, the tax administration of Seychelles. Alright. India has been once again chosen as a partner administration, and India will provide its tax expertise to the Seychelles so that their tax administration can be strengthened. Jo India ki tax expertise hai wo uski madad se Seychelles ka jo tax administration hai usko strengthen kiya jayega. All right, and India is already providing support under this program to these countries, Bhutan, Eswatini, Sierra Leone and Uganda. All right, now talking more about this program. So it is a capacity building program to strengthen the developing countries auditing capacity and international compliance across the world. And it is a joint initiative of UNDP and OECD, and this initiative, remember, was launched in the year 2015, and its secretariat is located at OECD only, which is of course in Paris. OECD ka headquarter kahan pe hai? Paris mein. And in Paris you will also find the headquarter of Reporters Without Borders, UNESCO, International Energy Agency, etc. And UNDP, where is the headquarter of UNDP? New York. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct answer. Seychelles. Seychelles capital is Victoria, and with Seychelles we do a joint military exercise which is known as Lambitte. So incorrect statement identify karna, it is a joint initiative of UNEP and OECD. Nahi, pehla hi statement mil gaya jo ki incorrect hai. That is not UNEP, that's UNDP. UNDP and OECD ka ye joint initiative hai, which means the correct answer will be what? Option A. So pehla hi option agar sahi mil jaye to maza aa jata hai jeevan mein. Question number 4. During DRDO Directors Conclave 2021, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh, his Lok Sabha constituency is Lucknow. Lucknow and ki Lok Sabha constituency presented Dare to Dream 2.0 Young Scientist Award. How many winners were awarded the Dare to Dream 2.0 Awards? देखो इस साल इस तरीके की जो न्यूज होती है उसमें से हमेशा एक नंबर का ही क्वेश्चन आएगा, उससे ज्यादा नहीं आ सकता. If there is an exam in which two markers are asked, like RBI है, NABARD है. So in those exams, इस तरीके के न्यूज से एक नंबर का ही क्वेश्चन आएगा. ओके, दो नंबर का क्वेश्चन नहीं आ सकता. यू कैनॉट फाइंड टू मार्कर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सच न्यूज. ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव मेड दिस क्वेश्चन. हाउ मेनी विनर्स वर अवॉर्डेड द डेयर टू ड्रीम 2.0 अवार्ड्स? कितने विनर्स को मिला है? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज. रक्षा मंत्री राजनाथ सिंह, डिफेंस मिनिस्टर राजनाथ सिंह हैज प्रेजेंटेड द डेयर टू ड्रीम 2.0 एंड यंग साइंटिस्ट अवार्ड टू द अवॉर्डीज. एंड इट वॉज अनाउंस्ड, the awards were presented during the DRDO Directors Conclave 2021, and the theme of the conclave, guys, was redesigning the processes to meet the national aspirations. Redesigning the processes to meet the national aspirations was the theme of this conclave. And talking about the Dare to Dream, so remember it is a nationwide contest of DRDO which is to promote Indian academician individuals and startups to develop. To develop what? To develop defense and aerospace technology systems. Defense and aerospace technology systems को में अच्छी-अच्छी technologies को develop करने के लिए ये contest है. And it is for, it invites academicians, individuals and the startups also. Alright. And under this, DRDO provides technical and financial support to the startups, to the individuals, to the academicians under the Technology Development Fund Scheme. टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपमेंट फंड स्कीम है जिसमें डीआरडीओ फंड्स देता है टू द इनोवेटिव आइडियाज. अंडर दैट फंड द फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड टू द डेयर टू ड्रीम कॉन्टेस्ट विनर्स. ऑलराइट, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द अवार्ड्स. सो डेयर टू ड्रीम 2.0 अवार्ड्स वर गिवन टू 40 विनर्स, 22 इन द इंडिविजुअल एंड 18 इन द स्टार्टअप कैटेगरी. व्हाइल द यंग साइंटिस्ट अवार्ड, यंग साइंटिस्ट आर गिवन टू दोस साइंटिस्ट हु आर अंडर द एज ऑफ 35. ओके, so 16 DRDO scientists under the age of 35 were awarded because of their outstanding contribution in their niche areas. All right, and Dare to Dream 3.0 was also announced. So now let's come back to the question. They are asking how many winners were awarded the Dare to Dream. So it is 40, 22 in individual and 18 in startup category. So moving ahead to question number 5, according to recently released agenda document for the year 21-22 by Ministry of Coal. Who is the Minister of Coal, by the way? Pralad Joshi. Pralad Joshi is the Minister of Coal, Mines and Parliamentary Affairs. Parliamentary Affairs, his Lok Sabha constituency is Dharwad. Dharwad is in Karnataka. What is the coal production target by 2024? So guys, remember, this is for the very first time that the Ministry of Coal has launched, has released such document, which is agenda document. And in this agenda document, everything is there. Like for example, what will be the target of production of coal, what reforms they want to, what reforms they want in the coal industry, how they can improve the coal industry, how they can enhance the electricity production from the coal, how they can improve the efficiency of coal thermal power plants. Basically everything related to the coal industry is there in this agenda document. Okay. Now of course, this agenda document completely is not important for the exam. Just two facts you have to remember. Number one fact, that this agenda document says that the production of target is 1 billion ton. 1 billion ton coal by the year 2024. 2024 tak 1 billion ton coal ka production target hai. And this agenda document is focused on the four areas. Char areas ke upar ye focus hai. Number one, coal sector reforms. And these are certain things that they will do under this coal sector reforms. Yeah, read kar lena PDF mein se. These are not important for the exam. These are just for the basic understanding that what they are doing under coal sector reforms. Then coal transition and sustainability, number two. Number three, institution building, and number four, futuristic agenda. So these are the four areas where this agenda document is focused, and the coal production target has to be achieved, how much? 1 billion ton by the year 2024. Okay. इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. Now let's come back to the question. They are asking about the target, which is 1 billion ton by the year 2024, which means option A will be the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number 6, which is the last question. Recently, the 9th meeting of India-UAE Joint Task Force on Investments was held. It was co-chaired by Piyush Goyal, the Minister of Commerce and Industry, and he is also the Minister of Food, Consumer Affairs and Public Distribution, and Minister of Textile bhi hai ye. Nahin, food ke nahi hai, sorry. I'm sorry, ye food ke minister nahi hai. Minister of Textiles hai, Minister of Commerce and Industry hai. Food ke minister pehle the. And he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. He is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. Alright. So he co-chaired this meeting, and the question is, when was India-UAE Joint Task Force on Investment established? Now remember, in this meeting, अगर इस meeting से कोई question आया तो यही होगा कि ये कब establish हुआ था, ठीक है? क्योंकि इसमें क्या discussion हुई थी, that is not important for the exam. So now this is the news that Piyush Goyal, who is the Union Minister of Commerce and Industry, has co-chaired the India-UAE Joint Task Force on Investment. And remember, this was established in the year 2013 as a key forum for promoting economic ties between the two countries, India and UAE. Alright. And these are some of the discussions that held during the meeting. Ye kuch discussions thi, ya padh lo. These are not important. Once again, these are not important for the exam. Impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on global trade. Positive outcomes achieved through the work of the joint task force to date. Then exploring ways to facilitate investment in both the countries. Alright. So the correct answer, guys, to this question would be option B, 2013. All right. So that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. So milte hain Monday ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.